G'day, welcome back. And we've got some updates in regards to short permissions, or as they now call it, short sampling. The first thing you're going to notice is when you go into a video, go down into the settings, where it used to say short permissions, it now says short sampling. A little bit of an image of that on the screen for you right now. Second thing, the bulk updating tool is here. And the reason why I knew this is because you can now sample long form video using the shorts camera. So if you have the shorts camera activated in your region, you can actually now use audio from long form content. Bit of a demo playing on the screen for you now, where I've pulled up YouTube on my Android phone. What you can see here is that I'm going into one of my own videos, and you can see there's a little icon there. It says create, clicked on that. It took the audio and popped me right into the shorts camera, where I could pick which 15 second selection of that audio I wanted to use, and then obviously record some additional visuals and things like that and turn it into a short. So it's up and it's running for those who have shorts. And an additional side note for news for shorts is now they've rolled it out to Canada, UK, and Latin America, many, many countries, Latin America, Mexico, and South America, all those places. It's being rolled out at present to those guys. So if you're in the UK, you're in Canada, or you're in Latin America, then have a look. You might see the shorts camera now available in your YouTube app. But now let's get to the bulk tool. Jump on over to the computer. As you can see here, I am in my channel content page on YouTube Studio. Say I select, say, a number of videos. I'm not going to select any shorts. But if you just go and tag the videos, you could just go up to the top and click all. But obviously, I don't want to affect shorts. I just want to go into some shorts. So I'm just going to pick a few videos here. That'll do. Those five. If I go up here to edit, if you scroll down there, there's a section called short sampling. I can click on that and I can change it from allow sampling to don't allow sampling. So there is the bulk opt-in or opt-out tool ready to go on your content. So if you go in your studio, you should be able to access that through the bulk updating tool that is built into the content page. To get to that again, so basically you select which videos you want. You go to edit, pull down the arrow, and scroll down to sampling. Click on sampling, and it will give you the option. Little information box pops up there if you hover. Allows people to create shorts using parts of your videos. Not allowing this will permanently delete any shorts that sampled your videos. Not all videos can be opted out. Interestingly, that wording does not mention audio specifically, although we know currently that it is only including audio presently. Again, if we go to the learn more page for this feature, nothing has really changed there. If we scroll there, you can see how to create shorts with audio content with all the same information that we discussed in former videos. We've got some additional imagery as well on how that all works. Not too much has changed there. It says that we can, what content can we use to make a short? You can create a short using a song from our music library in the shorts camera, of course, or the original audio from any other short and long form videos. So you can sample shorts, you can sample long form content. Some videos may be unavailable based on who has claimed copyright ownership or their privacy setting. For example, videos claimed by a third party copyright owner and private videos can't be used. We also allow creators to limit the use of audio from their long form videos in other shorts. If you choose to use audio from others' videos, the owner may delete the original content or restrict the use of their long form content in shorts at any time. When this happens, any derivative shorts will be audio muted, unlisted, and scheduled for deletion in 30 days. Don't worry, we'll email you a reminder before your short is deleted, so you can download a version that doesn't include the audio. This whole section is pretty new, but this basically gives you the overview and summary of how the short sampling works as a whole across the channel. There's some clarity here on some of the copyright issues, where it talks about if there's a video that's already claimed by third-party copyright, so if your video has a claim on it, then it's not going to be samplable. You're not going to be able to sample your video if it has a copyright claim on it. If videos are private, obviously, they're not even going to be discoverable to be able to use that. So at any time, if you delete a video, then any derivative shorts that are made from your video are going to be audio muted and privated. They're not going to exist publicly on YouTube anymore. Are there any more questions you might have around shorts sampling, the audio sampling feature, which is now rolled out for everybody who has a shorts camera? I've done a quick demo here on my phone. I showed you how to do the bulk updating tool in studio. So let me know if you have any more questions. I think it's becoming quite clear now. I don't think it's something that is to be too concerned about, unless, of course, you don't want yourself being sampled in some way. So in any case, let me know what you think. This is Doug, and I'll catch you later.
Subscribe to Doug Hewson YT for more tech for content creation.